Today, let us get into more details of your own small businesses and models. Models you didn't tell me actually, but let us try to structure in a formal way with more understanding. Okay. So yesterday, Meghna was talking about dairy or animal husbandry. Pavan was talking about paper plates and glasses. Kind of thing, environmental friendly, avoid to fight corona, more demand for that. Lalita talked about event management, catering services. Sakriya talked about signature recipe. Pravalika talked about boutique and so on. So now you just try to find out where you will fall in whichever is interesting, okay? First of all, before you do this, I understand some of you said big business in the previous sessions. So our topic, our course, our subject, all our sessions are dedicated to small business. So you need to understand what is a small business. Okay, so I made this. Can any one of you elaborate on this?
Sir, small business is nothing but below 5 crore. Our business, it is not okay. Listed in the companies.
Okay.
It's a turnover is a
minimum. So is this generic or very objective? How is it looking like?
Objective, sir.
Objective?
Yes, sir.
Sure. So what does this say? What is that I'm trying to say in this? Anyone?
It is owned privately, sir, mainly.
Correct, number one.
And with few employees and the scope means the operations or the activities, it is written that scope operations compared listed companies. It means it is compared to listed companies or something.
Correct. There is an error compared to listed companies. Listed company is a publicly limited company which gets listed in NSE, BSE kind of stock exchanges. It is much bigger, right? Its turnover, its employees, everything is much bigger. So compared to that, small business has very few employees. Maybe some small business may have only 2 employees. Okay. And its scope of operations is limited to maybe a small town or village or district or some state. Maybe sometimes pan India, but small business is all about small regions. Okay. That is the idea of me telling you this. So small in terms of people, small in terms of operations, small in terms of its scope, and small in terms of its investments also. You can go through the RBI's definition of a small business. If you want to get some subsidies from government, subsidized loans from banks, which are offered by state governments and central governments, then you need to have this kind of preliminary condition. It should be a minimum of 25 lakh or more than 25 lakh up to 5 crores. So 25 lakh, 1 rupee is also more than 25 lakh. So up to 5 crore. If this is the case, yes, you can call yourself that you are doing a small business. You are holding small business. You are owning small business. You are running small business. You have small business. You cannot say. I think in the other class, Meghna was saying, sir, I will be doing MSME. MSME comprises of micro, small and medium. So our course is confined only to small business. I wish you all are clear about the definition of a small business now. What do you say?
Yes, sir, we are clear.
Others? Only Meghna got clear? Others aren't?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, it is clear, sir.
Very clear. When you say small business, it should be between 25 lakhs, 5 crore. Na kam na zyada. Neither less nor more. తక్కువ కాదు ఎక్కువ కాదు యూ షుడ్ బి బిట్వీన్ దిస్ ఫైన్ సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ప్లాన్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ బిజినెస్ ప్లాన్స్ విల్ బి టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ దట్ రైట్ నౌ యూ హ్యావ్ టు షేర్ యువర్ బిజినెస్ ప్లాన్ టాక్ అబౌట్ యువర్ బిజినెస్ మోడల్ టాక్ అబౌట్ యువర్ బిజినెస్ ఐడియా ఇన్ దిస్ సెన్స్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి బొటేక్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి ఫుడ్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి ట్రావెల్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి ఇంటర్మీడియరీ సర్వీసెస్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి రియల్ ఎస్టేట్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి ఫార్మింగ్ ఎనీథింగ్ యూ షుడ్ హ్యావ్ దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ అ డెఫినేషన్ ఫైన్ Then, I was comparing small business with the business of listed companies. Okay, so maybe I'm straight away saying that no small business can be in the form of a listed company. In my experience, I never saw that. It does not mean they can't do it. There is some criteria. So most of the small businesses, not just in India, across the world. In Indian nomenclature, they are in this form: sole proprietary, partnership, one-person company, limited liability company, private limited company. Okay. Did we miss anything else? So, public limited and listed companies, MNCs, that is different. So, what is a one-person company? Tanuja.
So one person company it's a new concept it is a new concept sir
okay
and in this a nominee is mandatory
okay
a member in a one person company should be a nominee of another one person company sir
Very good.
It is a business organization when one person is the member and the shareholder with another shares.
Very good. So you got the PPT?
No, sir.
You got a quick search? Then you have got good memory. So okay.
Another question. Yes, sir.
Very good. That's the reason I took your name. So OPC is an alternative for what?
OPC, sir.
Instead of what you will be looking at OPC? Anyone?
Sole trader or sole proprietary.
Instead of that. Where business life is limited, you can look at OPC. Yatish, are you there?
Yes, sir.
What kind of business you have? What kind of organization form you have, Yatish, in your business?
Sole proprietary, sir.
Sole proprietary. Okay, good. Yes. Thank you. So, what is a limited liability partnership, Jahnavi?
Yes, sir. Hello.
Yeah, you're there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please let us know limited liability company. Or actually, there is an error there. It is not LLC. It is LLP, limited liability partnership. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Can you give your views?
Sir, limited liability company means the person itself is responsible for their debts, sir. Company's debts or liabilities.
Okay, very good.
Yes, sir.
Perfect. So, my question is, LLP is the alternative for what?
The partnership.
LLP or LLC in other countries, it is the alternative for partnership firms. Very good. Thank you very much.
Okay.
Then, what I did is, I gave some areas, okay? To talk about so all of you be ready with your own business. You have to talk for yourself. So these are the clues for you: which business form, what kind of business, business model, business idea, business plan, and so on. Be ready. I'm just hinting you something. Okay. So what I did is I gave some 12 or 15 sectors. You can just see that. Number one is food. Number two is tour and travel or travel and tour, and something related to gadgets. You can add more. I just gave some rough areas. They are self-explanatory. You can read them out. If you want to know something, you can ask me. I need not explain all these things. Okay. Fine. Then homemaking, mass gathering, farming. I think Naveen said he wanted to do organic farming. Lalita said the event management. Someone said the jewelry design, a blog. Is that Monica or someone? Pravalika. Pravalika said botic, I remember. Okay. Then construction services, skill services, tech skills. Okay. Then intermediaries, you can have an intermediary role, retail stores, then you yourself producing something. It is not a service, it is a paper, it is a wood, it is metal, it is construction material, it is a natural product, anything. You are making yourself. You are a producer, you are a maker. You can also have that. Then financial verticals in small business, educational services as small business, then health services as small business. Okay, these are quite interesting, easy to start. Anyone can start in any form of organization. You can start in your own place, small place, with very less number of employees under you, because this is small business. Okay, then what I did is, I was asking you about your business. I was asking you to elaborate with your business idea. And again, within that, I was asking you about your business model. Business model means how exactly you want to do. We can classify it as direct models, indirect models. So in direct model, you have a maker, you're manufacturing the product. You are manufacturing the product and selling. And dealer or distributor, you are a big scale distributor of a product produced by someone else, sold to someone. Okay. In the case of a maker, you are producing and you are selling directly. In the case of a dealer or distributor, you are selling others' products. You are distributing other products. Okay. It could be sometimes B2B also. It happens. Then retail stores, we all know what is a retail showroom, retail stop, retail shop, retail store, retail selling, everything. Then I think selling in your own way, from home or from other way, there are different models. If you want to sell yourself even without having a retail store, okay, without a brand, maybe freelance seller, you can say. Then franchisee, I think we'll talk about in detailed manner. That is a direct. Then indirect models, you can be an agent. You are just working on commission, not on, you cannot use the profits here. You cannot use the word profits here. You will be selling others' product or some. The major advantage here is the whole responsibility will not lie on you. It will be on the company's name. It will not be on you. You will be just getting the commission to resource or to get the lead and convert into sale. Then e-commerce, you are aware, you will be subscribing to some other's product and further selling it as your product. Let it be books, let it be electronic products, let it be electrical products. You buy massively from others and put your own name on that and try to sell as your own brand. Okay. An aggregator model, we discussed on this. Online business, anything online, everyone says online food, online jewelry, online tutoring, online classes, everything. And network marketing, Network marketing is something, you know, you might have heard about chain marketing, network marketing, retail selling kind of thing. That is also there. So out of all these 12 models, which is comfortable to you and which is not known to you, which you want some explanation?
Sir, aggregator.
One, then? What else? Who else? So others are clear to everyone. This is what I don't like. I will be asking you, please. Then okay, why should I wait for you? I'll pick you up and ask you. Sunil. Sunil. Is he present?
Absent, sir.
Geeta?
Yes, sir.
What is franchisee, Geeta?
Sir, you told it.
Sorry?
You will explain.
This is what I don't like. This is really killing. I clearly told you any question. Did you understand? You are calm and silent. Then you are saying you will explain. You are blaming me. How irritating to any faculty this kind of... Please understand that. That's the reason I'm asking you any question, anything you want me to explain. I will explain. That's my job. But I want you to ask me. Everyone knows everything, all 12 models. Why you're not asking? Only Meghna is coming forward. When I try to question you, you blame me. Sir, your PPT is not clear. Sir, your voice is not audible. Sir, your video is not clear. Instead of that, if you have a question, just ask me what is there. Tanuja?
Yes, sir.
What is aggregative?
Aggregative.
Quickly. Pavan?
Sir,
yeah, go on.
Sir, I know only there are some elements.
See, question is very... ee bhayam meeku eppudu potundo, meeku manchi alavadu eppudu vastundo naaku ardham kavatledu amma. వాట్ ఈస్ అగ్రిగేటర్ అన్నాను. ఇది ఎగ్జామ్ కాదు, ఏమిక ఎందుకు అంత భయపడుతున్నారో నాకు అర్థం కావట్లా. ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ జస్ట్ రెస్పాండ్. జస్ట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ యు నో టెల్ అబౌట్ దట్ అగ్రిగేటర్ తనుజ, యాజ్ సింపుల్ యాజ్ దట్. మీరు విపరీతంగా ఆలోచించేసి ఏమంటే సార్ ఏమంటారో, ఏమంటే ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఏమనుకుంటారో, విపరీతమైన ఆలోచన వచ్చేస్తుంది. గో అట్ తనుజ, టెల్ మీ, టెల్ మేఘనా, టెల్ అస్, ఐ విల్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్.
Sir, aggregator means it is some type of mortgage.
Okay. So that's what I was asking, you know, out of these 12, which one you want to know more? I was asking you, but no one is responding. Okay, at least now you ask me, then only I will explain. Geeta, now you got my question?
Yes, sir.
If you don't ask me, I will not explain. Pastor, anyone can ask anything. If you know about it, there is no point of discussing about it. That is the idea.
So,
yeah, go on. Pastor, please.
Sir, network marketing, sir.
Network marketing, one. Aggregator, then?
Franchisee, sir.
Franchisee, three. Then? Only three. Others are okay for you? If it is okay, I will ask you. Please be ready. If it is not okay, ask me.
Sir, subscription.
Very good. Subscription, good. Then?
Agent, sir.
Okay. Agent, you don't know.
Sir, means what is the difference between retailer and an agent, sir, or distributor and an agent?
No, agent is, we cannot compare agent with retailer. In that case, we need to talk about dealer, distributor, retailer, maker, everyone. What I'm trying to say is, agent, you might have heard about the word agent, right?
LIC agent, sir.
LIC agent, real estate agent, admissions agent, import-export agent, there are agents. Okay? Agents work on commission. I think I was already in my brief introduction also, I was telling you. Agents, they work on commission. Even many times, sellers and buyers, they don't know the agent also. And they have no role to play. Yeah.
Can we say them as brokers? Means Sorry? Agents are the brokers or brokers?
Yeah, good. That's a good one. Thanks for reminding me. As an intermediary, as Lalita was talking about agent, you can include brokers also here. Agents, brokers, they fall in the same category. Okay? Clear, Lalita?
Okay, sir.
And don't misunderstand, agent does not mean only companies or only individuals. A company can be an agent. Okay? Bajaj Capital Services, it distributes, it sells all financial products, including life insurance, mutual funds, and so on. Okay? So maybe that could be a question there. Good. So as you guys are asking, subscription means I order something in bulk and try to sell in retail. Okay? Say, for example, many companies, they import the products, electronic phones, chargers, headphones or earphones, electronic gadgets. They get it in bulk, they import from other countries and put their brand and try to sell it. Okay, that is subscription model of selling or doing small business. Network marketing is, I think Amway is quite popular for that. Network marketing. Actually, we cannot consider that as a small business because we don't see them. We don't see at the organizational level. Only independent people are, if you want to do network marketing, you cannot make it as a business. Okay. But there are, not in India, in other parts of the world, business is done using network marketing or retail selling. Okay, so don't get confused with Amway, Modi, Vestige kind of network marketing, which is sold like insurance policies kind of thing. We are not talking about that kind of thing. That is not business at all. Okay, business means you establish a very good organization with a brand, marketing, and so on, everything belongs to you. Okay. So that's the difference between network marketing done by retailers, network marketing done through small business. Then the franchisee, I think franchise business is the biggest. McDonald's, I don't think McDonald's operates on franchisee. Let me check out, or you can check it out. Lenskart is there. Lenskart is the best example in India to flourish.
Franchisee.
McDonald's is a franchisee, sir.
Franchisee, sir.
Okay, thank you. Good. Thank you. So most of the, how about KFC?
It is also a franchisee,
yes, sir.
Good. So I tell you are far better than me in talking about food franchises. So what they do is furniture, food, opticals, garments, you know, what they do is they call for invite franchises. What they do is they design the workspace, they give the product, they train the employees, they train the sales executives, they train the admin people how to operate on computer, how to send the reports and so on, how to do the billing, everything they will do. But the ownership and liability and other things, it is very easy to start actually. Okay. It's very easy. There was a small franchisee of a Russian brand that is beside Central. You know, anyone? There is a small temple, and beside the temple, there was a food franchisee, Russian food franchisee. And it was very costly, and it was with one of my known student's brother. And he came to me, I suggested him, it is too costly because nearby people are trying to flock to Central. They like the mall experience. So that is not a good place. And I suggested him 2 years back, he started. I think, I don't know how it is doing now, I forgot. Raffles something. That is the food franchisee. So that is the, if you have money, that is easy to start. You get good brand also. That is franchisee. Then aggregator model, you see National Stock Exchange, Bombay Stock Exchange. These are online now. But in the olden days, they provided a platform to sellers and buyers of the shares. In Vizag, we had Vishakhapatnam Steel City Stock Dealers Association, something. They provide a platform for buyers and sellers. It is an aggregator model. It is not broking, it is not agency. They provided a platform professionally to trade the shares. So like that, now you have aggregate model for tours, travel, ticketing, restaurants, food, Zomato, Swiggy. These are the examples of aggregators in the large scale. You can also think about an aggregator in the small scale with an app or web-based in your own region or some other platform. Okay, aggregator does not, you take Ola. Ola doesn't own a single car, but it does big, I think one of the biggest services in India, taxi services in India, but it doesn't own a car. Okay, and don't get confused with Oyo Hotel. Oyo Hotel is not a grand aggregator model. It is a leasing model or ownership model. Oyo is not a aggregator model. Ola is a aggregator model. Okay, then Flipkart is an aggregator model. There are many, Swiggy, Zomato, Uber Eats, all are aggregator models. Fine. So I just introduced. Now these things are clear to you all, friends?
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Yeah, others, thanks. Please now. Yeah, others, please quickly let me know, those who didn't share their business plans. Which is your, what is your business? What is your business model? Yatish, you said yours is sole proprietary, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So as Tanuja told that sole proprietary can be substituted by OPC, then why you are not looking at OPC? Can you share with us?
Sir?
Sole proprietary, the alternative for sole proprietary is OPC. You know OPC, right?
Yes, sir. One man, one person company.
One man RBA. One person company, correct. So why, yes, you are not looking at OPC? I just wanted to know, all of you, please talk freely. That's very, very important. Why you are not looking at OPC? Why you are looking at sole proprietary?
Sir, I'm looking at sole proprietary because no one is disturbing our idea of selling or taking decisions, sir. That's no why I'm choosing a one. That but means
no when what I, do you mean by no? What?
Sir, when I take decisions regarding our business, I am the only responsible for that, sir, for that idea.
No, even OPC is also the same. What do you say, Tanuja?
But
yes, sir, OPC is similar to sole proprietorship, but in OPC, liability is limited, sir.
Are you hearing that, Sunil? Liability is also limited. You have an advantage. No one will disturb you. Why you are not looking at OPC?
I don't
okay. I'll tell you why we don't. Most of the small businesses, they don't look at OPC. The reason here is when you are into OPC, it's a company, right? There are legal compulsions. Okay, in sole proprietary, you do the IT returns once in a year for yourself, including business returns. Nothing, everything is done. You not do anything. You not break your head. But in OPC, your income is different from your company's income. That is a major headache people feel. Whenever I ask my ex-students, friends who are doing business right now, they said the same thing. Okay, so still, as Tanuja was saying, your liability is limited. For example, if you take loan on your business and you don't repay, banks will claim on your vehicle, your home, your smartphone, everything they will claim. But if it is OPC, the loan taken on OPC means liability is limited to the assets of the OPC. They cannot ask your own car or two-wheeler or home. They will not come to you. That's an advantage you have. You just look at that, work on that. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, Meghna, can you pick someone who didn't share the business model?
Sir, let me check, sir.
Yeah. Someone said food truck. Who is that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Shravya. Shravya Krishna.
Yes, sir.
So you got somebody to talk about your business, Shravya?
Sir, I want to start a food truck, sir. The form of business is sole proprietor. I want to sell bakery items like cake, cupcake, sandwich, coffee, these kind of things. I would like to lease a truck, sir.
Okay, good.
Okay, then, sir, the assets of my business would be, sir, the kitchen items like stove, oven. These are the assets. I would like to target the customers like the college students. The location I have decided like is beside a college, so that it will be easy, and every college student is fond of these items, bakery items. So okay, that's it, sir. And people and team is like, I want to hire one cook or someone who can make these things. And
oh,
I will
God,
be there.
Very clear, very clear. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
And she without any hesitation, she just narrated the whole story. I can understand what kind of a homework, what kind of preparation you have done. Thank you very much, Shravya.
Thank you.
And
sir,
she is very clear. She got the target customers. Why she has put bakery items in her food truck is students like those things more. No, I see a lot of people at Fresh Choice more than canteen, right? They want bakery items. Maybe that's what she had. And one more thing to tell about you, Shravya. She got a very good business mindset. She doesn't want to buy a truck immediately. She wants to try with a lease truck, maybe monthly or quarterly or yearly. That's a very good idea. You cannot burn your hands by putting the whole money by buying a truck. That's a fantastic idea for a business person. I think you can make it serious and try to roll on. You're so good. in business sense, I can say that, Shravya. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Meghna, did you pick up?
So, Geeta.
Yeah, Geeta.
Yes, sir.
Yes, madam. Good afternoon, madam.
I want to export aloe vera because aloe vera nowadays it is medical. Yes, sir.
Meghna, are you recording? Are you writing?
Shall I write, sir?
Writing means in Excel or on paper. Please update it in Excel, okay? Because this is very precious.
It is already. Okay? I have done it. I have it.
You done it, but now students are becoming more specific. You can add those details also.
Okay, sir. I will do that.
Because now Geeta is specifically saying earlier maybe she told you farming. Now she is very clearly telling aloe vera, and she wants to export. That is her idea.
Yes.
Please record this. Yeah, go ahead, Geeta.
Nowadays, almost all cosmetic items and all medical things are coming under aloe vera, sir. So that I am thinking about why can't we export aloe vera from here? We have land, we have, and there is no specific soil for that, sir. And there is no specific climatic condition and all. And mostly for a hectare in a year, we will get up to 2,30,000, sir. Sir, I'm preferring for that.
Okay. Sir. So you have your piece of land with you already?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how much land you want to do this aloe vera?
Well, first of all, I don't know where to export and how to export. First, I will
see. First of all, you have to make aloe vera right in your agricultural field.
Yes, sir.
In what area? In how much spread of your agricultural land you will do it? In half an acre? 1 acre, 10 acres.
For 1 acre, I will do it, sir.
So how much land you have, Geeta?
Almost I have 11 to 12 acres.
Okay, so in all these 11 to 12 acres, you can't do farming, right? So how much land you want for this aloe vera?
Sir, actually. Only land we can't do in our upstairs, we can do in gardening area.
No, if it is hobby or you doing for personal care, you can do this on your terrace, okay? But if you want to do business, you need more terrace space, right?
Okay, sir.
So now you have to go to the next level. You should be very clear on what kind of aloe vera you want to do it. Are you doing it for exporting the aloe vera plant? Are you doing it for derivative products of aloe vera which are useful for skincare kind of thing? Are you are doing that final product? You are doing for intermediary product? You are doing for raw product as a plant? Okay, you should be very clear. Next time you have to tell us. So terrace is definitely not it's a small space. If it is a big space, you should tell us how much SFT, how many pots, its capacity is how many plants. Okay, you should say like that.
Yes, sir.
Then only if you want some money, if you want some loans, You should tell the banker. You should tell the investor. You should tell your own parents or your own family members. If you say everything in air, they will not be convinced with you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank I think yes, you have done a good job to with this. Your PPT is more practical. That made my students talk more about it. So if you have any question, so now we are in the second unit. You have to, planning is over in first unit. In the second unit, you need to roll your business. You should talk about rolling your business. So if you're starting your business, the last step of a business plan is executing the business plan. Okay. So the second unit is structuring your business or executing the business plan. Today I gave you different varieties of verticals in different areas. In each area, 5 to 10 areas I gave you. So your business falls in which area, and try to get more information on that. Okay. And you be clear on sole proprietary, partnership, PLC, OPC or private limited company, which organizational form you want to make. Like just now Geeta told about aloe vera. She wants to make directly, or she wants to buy from someone and export it. Okay. So what is your role, direct or indirect? Indirect means it could be agency model, as Lalita asked me, broker model, as Meghna asked me. It could be an aggregator model, most of you asked me. It could be online, it could be e-commerce, it could be anything. If you want to do it directly, are you making the product? Are you directly selling to someone? Are you distributing the product in a massive way in your own region, selling to retail shops? Are you selling in retail? So it's all up to you. Okay. So be clear with all these things. Next session, next week on Monday will be very interesting if you are clear. Thank you very much. I think you came to the session with more preparation. Attendance is also good. Interaction is also good. Still, if you have a question, you can ask me.
It is interesting, sir, and precise too.
Yeah, good. Okay. There's no question. You're done for the day. Thank you all. Have a nice weekend.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.